Let me apply this second quantization to a concrete maybe situation which we have. I mean, namely, so we should apply to contraction. So do we know nice contractions operators of norm 1 or less than 1 on the underlying on some Hilbert space? And of course, what we considered at some point were unitary groups given by unitary operators, and unitary operators of course have norm 1, so we can essentially apply the second quantization to unitary groups. And maybe I want to make a remark corresponding to this, because unitary groups also have generators, that's our self-adjoint operators, and maybe it's nice to see what happens with them under this second quantization. Okay, so let's say we consider a unitary group, so which is ut of e to the iht. H is the generator of this guy, so this is a self-adjoint operator which can also be unbounded in general. So let this be a unitary group on H. So this means if H is the one particle space, we have a Hamilton operator, and this gives us the time evolution on this. So this means ut describes the dynamics on the one particle space. And of course, the question is, I mean, can we lift this dynamics to the n particle spaces? And the second quantization is what should do this. Yeah, so we can take the second quantization of the uts. This of course gives us then a unitary group on the nth level, because the gamma, the second quantization, preserves the multiplicative structure. That's the only thing which is important for unitary groups. And yeah, the u's are also unitary guys on the base level. And of course, from this, it follows that they are also unitary then after this quantization. So it follows that if I take gamma plus n of ut, so this is now for each n, this is a unitary group on the tensor power. So this is a unitary group on H, on the H to the n, the symmetric part of this. And what is the generator? Yeah, now of course the generator of ut on the base level is this H, but now the generator, maybe first guess is it should be the second quantization of this H. But if you remember, I mean, that you get the generator from taking the differentiating this guy, and if you have a product and you take the derivative, you will get a sum of different terms. And actually, it turns out, well, it's maybe quite easy to see, but maybe you should do it for yourself. So this has a generator, which is in a sense a quantized version of this guy. So it's not, maybe let me just write it down. So I denote it by d of gamma, just as a quantized version, a differential of gamma plus n of now H. So this is not H tensor H tensor H, but actually it is the sum of H tensor 1 tensor 1. So it's H acting on the first component plus 1 tensor H tensor 1 plus and so on. So H acting on the second component plus 1 tensor 1 tensor 1 tensor H, H acting on the last component. And for this, of course, I need the tensor product where the operators are not all the same, but of course, I mean, I think it is clear what this here means. So this is this thing. And then in this language, so that this is the generator, then I can write that the quantization of e to the second quantization of the semigroup is given by e to the I, and now I get here as a generator the differential second quantization of this operator H times t. And now again, I can of course take all of them together, not just for fixed n, but taking the direct sum over all n's, and then I get what I really call the second quantization. I mean, quantization means not just doing it for a fixed n, but doing it for all n simultaneously. So if I now take the direct sums of all those guys, and this I denote by d gamma plus of h, so this is a direct sum from 0 to infinity of d gamma plus n of h. And this guy lives on the symmetric Fock space, on the symmetric Fock space we have then really this relation here without the n, just in general. So gamma plus e to the I h t is equal to e to the I d gamma plus of h times t. Yeah, so this gives me the relation between lifting a unitary group and lifting the generator. And lifting happens in two different ways. On the level of the group, it's like taking just the product of everything. On the level of the generators, it's taking this sum here, which is a kind of differential version of the product. And I mean, this relation is like between Lie groups and Lie algebras. That's more or less what we are doing here. And yeah, as I already said, this d gamma plus is called the differential second quantization. So I mean, there are actually two ways of lifting things from the base level to the higher level. Maybe the most canonical one is the second quantization, where I just take the product. But this lifting is also a very canonical way, in a differential way. So it's also kind of second quantization, but it is called a differential one. It's called differential second quantization of H. Yeah, and whereas, I mean, our unitary groups are always unitary and thus contractions, so I'm always lift bounded operators, but of course the generators of our unitary groups typically are unbounded operators. So I mean, at least for this H here, I should of course also typically consider the situation that H is not necessarily a bounded operator, but it can also be an unbounded operator. And then of course in this lifting, one should also, in this quantization, check what happens with the domains. But this can of course be done. So really, I mean, I can lift a self-adjoint operator on H to really a self-adjoint operator on all those ends. So this really can be done, but I don't want to go into the details here now. But I mean, what really our goal is now, we should define creation and annihilation operators. We have now set the stage, we have the Hilbert space, the bosonic Fock space, but we are still missing the crucial operators. We want to represent the CCR, canonical commutation relations there, and we need this in terms of creation and annihilation operators. So I really should define on the Fock space our creation and annihilation operators.